There are, okay, cooperativism has been introduced a long while, but you know, I can see that there are good number of success stories, but much of these cooperatives that have been organized before pulled it up. Now, why did they pull that? Maybe I would attribute that to, you know, a systematic approach by government to nurture an environment of cooperativism. So continuous institution building must be there, continuous skills development, and strengthening their management systems, everything. Or even bringing professional managers to work with them so that they elevate their game in terms of, you know, production, now, for example, processing and marketing. So there's a lot of building up the capacities for these cooperatives. Now, I can mention a number of good multi-purpose cooperatives that have gone from small beginnings to now big cooperatives. The Nueva Segovia Consortium of Cooperatives based in Cagayan, Ilocos Sur. Now, from a small beginning, they are now 2 billion, they have now 2 billion worth of assets. They are not only helping their members do produce products that they also market, but they are also helping them you know, do marketing of this produce and setting up stores, strategic areas. Now, another one that can be mentioned is there is a Federation of Agricultural Farmers Cooperatives in Pangasinan called Albacopa. And this is a land bank of the Philippines organized federation of cooperatives. So today there are 22 primary cooperatives that are members to this federation, and they're now in the business of marketing inputs for the membership. They're also marketing the produce of the member farmers. So there are a good number of these that we can cite. There is also one called ACDI, Multi-Purpose Cooperative, which is a group of retired generals of the Air Force. Now, their main business is in agriculture, dairy, in corn production, so and other businesses, even native chicken production and the like. So they have strong base, and they're worth billions of pesos already.